Students, so today we are with the maths class 7 and the chapter of that particular is simple interest. So we are going to see the terms related to simple interest. First of all, SI, we write that SI generally denotes the simple interest, what interest it is taken in that particular amount or money. Okay, P is the principal, R is the rate of interest, T is the time, and A is the amount. Means A is the amount, means it is the sum of principal and interest over there. So coming to the formula for the simple interest, so SI equals to principal into rate into time divided by 100. Clear? So further from this particular formula, we are having means only one formula, and that is transformed in the other form. Okay, so when we have to find P, then we can write that simply this 100 is multiplied over here and these two are coming in the denominator, means rate and time. So similarly, principal equals to simple interest into 100 by rate of interest into time. Rate equals to simple interest into 100 divided by principal into time. Time equals to simple interest into 100 divided by principal into rate. So when we are going to find amount, so amount is the sum of simple interest and the principal given over here. So now we are coming to the exercise. So we are coming to the question, find the simple interest and amount, and the data it is given that principal equals to, means we can write P equals to rupees of 250. Time it is given 3 years. And rate of interest it is given 6 months. So R equals to, sorry, rate of interest 6%. So rate of interest equals to 6% given over here. So when we have to calculate the, means first of all we have to calculate simple interest. After that, when we will add simple interest to the principal, then we will get the amount over here. So the formula for finding simple interest, that is principal into rate into time divided by 100. So this is the formula over here, and we are going to put the values to get simple interest over here. So 250 is multiplied with 6 is multiplied with 3 divided by 100. So from 100 we will cut that 2 times, and this we will get in 5 times and 3 times. Clear with this? So simple interest over here, that is equals to 5 into 3 into 3, that is equals to 45. Okay, this is in rupees form. So when we are going to calculate this particular amount over here, so amount, we represent amount with A over here. Okay, amount equals to principal plus simple interest, we can write. So amount equals to principal, we have got 250 over here, and simple interest we have got 45. So when we will add that, we will get amount equals to 295 rupees. So this is the answer. Okay. So we are coming to question number 2, where we have to find principal over here. And what it is given, that means a principal we have taken, means given the question, there is some principal. Okay, we will take that principal, we will assume that as P. And that will amount to 8480 rupees in 3 years. Okay, 3 years. And the rate of interest is given 2%. So how to calculate this particular question? So amount we are having over here, that is rupees 8480. Time we are having over here 3 years, and rate of interest, that R equals to, we are having 2% over here. Clear with this? These are the given data over here. So now we will calculate first simple interest. SI equals to principal into rate into time divided by 100. But the thing is that P is given, not given over here. So we will take that, let principal be P. Means we are assuming that principal has P on over here. Okay. Means in the place of principal, we will write P only. So simple interest, SI equals to P into, what is the rate over here? Rate is given 2. What is the time over here? 3. Okay, time is given 3. So divided by 100. Okay, now simple interest SI equals to 6P by 100. So we have got simple interest in terms of P over here. Clear? Now we are coming to that, the formula of amount. Amount equals to simple interest plus principal. This is the formula. So amount, what we are having? We are having rupees 8480. That is equals to simple interest. We have got 6P by 100 plus P. Clear with this? So now we will find that principal over here. So 8
equals to 6p plus 100p divided by 100. So this 100 will be multiplied over here and this will be added, and so we can write it over here like this: 848000 equals to 106p. So what we have got? This is the means this value will be divided with 106. So principal equals to rupees 848000 divided by 106. So we will divide this with 106, then we will get the principal over here. So when we will divide it with 106, then we will get around 8000 over here. So the principal over here, that will be equals to 8000 rupees. So now we are coming to question number 4. In this particular question, it is given that the interest on rupees 500 amounts to rupees 60 in 2 years. At the same rate of interest per annum, in how much time will 800 will amount to this much? So first of all, we need to find rate over here. So what it is given in the this question? In this question, it is given that means we are having two cases. So writing that case 1 and case 2. Okay. Case 1. And the data for the case 1, it is given that principal equals to 500 rupees. Simple interest, that is equals to rupees 60. Time, it is given 2 years. Okay. So now what we will do? We will find that simple interest. We will apply in the formula of simple interest equals to principal into rate into time by 100. So what we can do? We have to find that rate over here. Then rate equals to SI into 100 divided by P into T. Up to here it is clear. Now what we will do? We will put the values over here. So rate of interest, that is equal to simple interest, we have got 60 into 100 divided by 500 into 2 years it is given. Okay, this we are eliminating. So from 2 it is 30. So we have got rate equals to 6% over here. So this is the rate of interest. What we have got? The rate of interest is equals to 6%. So now we are coming to the second case. What if the case 2 it is given? So in that case it is given that the principal is rupees 800. So 800 is the principal. Time we have to find over here. Rate it is given over here, that rate is equals to 6%, what we have got over here. Okay, and amount is equals to 1232. So this we are having over here. So we have to calculate the time over here. So what is the formula for amount? Amount equals to simple interest plus principal. So first of all, we will find the simple interest. Simple interest equals to P into R into T. Formula is written over here. So directly I am putting the value over here. 800 into we are having rate equals to 6% into time we are having T. Okay, that is divided by 100. Clear with this? So this we are getting as a simple interest, but we have to calculate the simple interest over here. So simple interest is equals to what? Amount minus principal. So SI equals to A minus of T. So SI equals to amount, what we are having? 1232 minus of 800. Clear with this? So when we will subtract this, then we will get 432 over here. So that is the simple interest. So 432 equals to 800 into 6 into T by 100. So now eliminating over here only. Okay. So now we have to calculate the T. T equals to 432 divided by 8 into 6. So we will cut this with 54. Okay. 54 times when we will get that, and when from 6 we will cut that at 9 times. So T equals to 9 years. So this is the solution for this particular question. Coming to question number 8. In this, Aman earn rupees 1470. Okay, as an interest after 3 years. Time is given 3 and 7 is the rate of interest at 7% per annum. So what we are having data over here? We are having simple interest, that is equals to rupees 1470 time we are having 3 years. After that we are having rate of interest that is equals to 7%. So these are the data given over here. So how much did he invested we have to find. So what is the invested? Invested is the principal. Okay. So we have to find principal over here. Okay. So we are having formula for this. SI equals to principal into rate into time by 100. Okay. So we will put the value over here, or you can further write that P equals to SI into 100 divided by principal into rate. Rate into time. Okay. So this is the formula over here. So now putting the values, SI we are having 1470 is multiplied with 100, that is further divided with 3 into 7. So when we will calculate this particular, then from 7 I am dividing 2 times, 1 times, 0 times. So from 3 I will divide, that it will be 70 into 100. So principal over here, that is equals to rupees 7000. So this is the solution for this particular question. And what you have to do, you have to solve rest of the question including example in this chapter. So thank you.